Hello and welcome to Season 6, Episode 2 of The Honey Box with myself, Lucas Yeomans.
And me, Emily Rose Galvin.
With our live studio audience as well. Make some noise, studio audience. Lovely to see you all here. We have got a very special show for you today. The lineup includes Cathy Jain.
Soulmates sometimes don't get together.
We've got the very, very lovely Charlotte Bettson.
And let's kick off episode 2, season 6, with Jupiter's Beard.
Night till morning, we're passengers. The cinematography of our little history. I watch them for see what comes. The moments like dance steps ingrained into my head. I twirl and I twist and jump. All my wounds speak.
Somewhere with people who look up and see.
Okay, you know how we do it by now on the Honey Box. You get to hear these amazing artists perform, but also have a little chat with them as well. Delight to say that Spence from Jupiter's Beard is with us now. How have you found your Honey Box experience so far, mate?
It's been really good. We've always kind of wanted to come and play, but we've never had the chance before. But yeah, it's good. It's good today.
Do you want to give a shout out to everyone playing with you today as well, Spence?
Yeah, so we've got Simon on the drums, we've got Luke on the bass, and Nathan is joining us on the keyboard today.
Top man. We'll talk about last year first, but being the first show of 2023. Mm-hmm. You've released some songs, had a great final gig of the year as well. Do you want to talk through your highlights of 2022 for us?
Yeah, so I'd say the highlights for us especially was like we were able to support Scouting for Girls at Keele SU. It was kind of a bigger gig than we were used to, because I think the Sugar Mill, where we kind of used to headline, is 300, 400 if I'm correct. Mm-hmm. But then Keele was like a good 1,000 people, which was really good for us. 2022 as well saw us move in together. We got like a little flat together.
Oh yeah, I've seen.
which was quite fun. We kind of went in thinking we were going to make loads of music, which we did, but we also got really good on FIFA as well.
Who's your only players?
Well, England.
Who's the best, actually? Who's the best at FIFA? Be honest here, be honest.
I'd probably say Salah.
Okay, it's very noble of you. Very good. Yeah. Very modest, very modest. But you also said you played at Keele as well, didn't you?
Yes.
You go to Keele too. So that must have been great as well, because, you know, it kind of feels like a bit of a homecoming in a way.
Definitely. It was nice because we were kind of able to pull in a crowd as well, kind of knowing people at uni. They would all come and support us as well.
So a few single releases too last year?
Yeah, so we released Sunrise, which is the song we're going to play next. And we kind of tried something a bit different with that. We kind of used a brass section rather than just your standard kind of guitars.
2023, what's happening? What have you got planned?
So we are going to try and finish our album. We've kind of got some of it in the bag already. I think we've got about 4 tracks left to kind of do. We are going to be sort of gigging as well. So we're looking at festivals this year. We're looking at gigs in Coventry and around the Cannock area and things like that. Just try and break out of Stoke. As well.
So there's stuff to see. There's you guys playing FIFA at home, or if not, you guys gigging. If not, you guys releasing some stuff.
Yeah.
Social media is probably the best place to see all this happening. Where do we go for that?
So it's Jupiter's Beard Official on I think all of them. Yeah. So Instagram, Facebook, and everything on Spotify as well, and Apple Music.
Pretty unique name. Easy to find. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Easy pretty much.
Okay. Thank you very much, Spencer. We'll be here for you guys a little bit later on. Right now, if you don't mind, making some noise for our performance again from Cathy Jain.
I notice you acting weirdly, nice to me. Better not think you have a chance, you know I'm way too trendy. I know I admire but what can I do? Stop eyeing me, you know I won't choose you. The only thing you'd be is a tool. No, I'm not into you. Did your friends tell you that? I don't even know who you are by your back. You must be so upset. You must be so impressed. Cause every time you always meet my eye in the halls, you make it so damn obvious I'm honestly shocked. You must be so. Tell you that I don't even know.
So in this part of the show, as well as having fantastic interviews from all the artists that we've got here today, we'd like to invite a guest along to talk about celebrations, organisations, important issues that are going on in the local scene. You may or may not be aware of some of the conversations that have been happening around the future of BBC introducing and local radio. And we thought, who better to talk us through some of those changes?
Oh, me?
Then our lovely Lucas. Hi, Lucas. How are you doing? Are you enjoying
Very
Honeybox?
Well. I actually, I know this is going to sound like I'm saying it for the sake of saying it, I'm having a great time, Emily Rose Garvey.
I'm so pleased. I'm so pleased.
Time.
He does have to say that, but also he is having a fantastic time. So other than obviously Honeybox, which is incredibly important, for those people who don't know, what else is it that you do and how are you linked in with the BBC?
So, yeah, I've been working in and around the BBC for many years, since about 17. And I actually started off by working on BBC Introducing from Stoke. So now I'm lucky enough to travel all around the UK, working on various different jobs, radio, TV, whatever, anything like that. But still managed to work on the local Introducing show that I started when I was 17. And it's such an important show. And obviously with this being a local music show, in Stoke, it's very difficult to get that recognition for the local artist. So it's a massive. I wouldn't do it if I didn't love it.
No, of
hence
course not.
Why I'm still.
Well, you're a big shot now.
Episode.
You're a big shot.
Well,
Lucas,
no,
so.
I just give it someone else a try. But I'm selfish.
Of course. So I mean, some of the artists in this room have been featured on BBC Introducing. But what exactly is it that that show does for the local music community?
Well, local introducing shows all around the UK. So there's every single local radio station has its own local introducing show. And the idea is that they give local artists a chance to get their song on the radio. And that can lead on to some amazing stories. Cathy's a great example of that, who got played at introducing. And she then got picked by Radio 1 for the Radio 1 Live Lounge competition a few years ago. So that's just an example of what it can do for you. So it's really important.
Really important. So can you explain a bit to us about proposed measures or changes to the lineup?
I'm going to give you all a politician's answer here, I'm afraid. I've got to be careful what I say. But basically, with times and change and everything like that, the BBC are trying to implement some different ideas, different changes, and with that will come cuts to live broadcasting as well. So the plan is to bring a lot of the local network stuff to a more sort of regionalised base and national base, which means that shows like BBC Music Introducing may not be local. So local music may not get as much of a chance to be showcased. We don't know what the plans are yet, and nothing's set in stone. There's nothing confirmed. It's all conversations right now, which I guess is why it's really important for us to have this chat and let people know that this is happening.
Absolutely. And I mean, predicting, I predict a politician's answer again, but if that does go ahead, what is the effect going to be on not just Stoke's music scene, but local music scenes across the country?
It'll all depend on what they do, and it'll all depend on how the shows are going to be shaped. But of course, you know, a two-hour radio show for local music from Staffordshire and Cheshire, if that doesn't exist, then, and it's shared with a few other local shows, the chances are not as many artists are going to get played on the radio, which is ultimately, I think, what everyone wants to be doing when they're
of
making
course,
music.
So. Absolutely, absolutely. So what can we do? We're in a room full and being watched by people who are obviously into local music and want to support it. What can we do to prevent that happening and to keep supporting local music?
I think what you need to do is, because it's all dependent on what people hear and what they see the feedback is, make your voices heard. Tom Robertson, who presents Fresh on the Net on BBC Six Music, has put a post up where you can sort of, it's almost like a form that you can sort of send your requests and your thoughts in, your feelings, the importance of local music in your area. Get that message out there. It will be, I think, heard from the big boss of the BBC. And if you want to make your voice heard, then do that by looking at Fresh on the Net on Twitter.
Thanks, Lucas. Thanks very much. And in the same vein, celebrating fantastic local music, we'd love to hear some more from the wonderful Cathy Jain.
Afternoon, I'm sitting by the river with you. You're cool in your retro indie colorful shoes. You're playing a song I don't really like, but I'm nodding my head to the beat. I don't really mind. You talk for quite a long time. I join in when I feel like sometimes. We kiss and then we say goodbye. Guess I feel alright by your side, 'cause I got that faking kind of love. Won't you tell me about your life? 'Cause I'll be a silent pretty girl who'll tell you all the lies to make you feel nice. I know all your friends, they go to our school. Infamous little gang, they say that you're the cool kids. Damn, you're such a cool kid. Tell me about your life.
I'm back here with my interviewer, head on, with the lovely Charlotte Bettson. Hello, Charlotte. How are you doing?
Hi, I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm okay, thank you. I'm okay. Have you been enjoying Honeybox?
Yeah, it's been a really good experience. Like, it's a pleasure to be here with all these amazing artists as well.
Yeah. Fantastic. Yeah, it has been like a really, really solid lineup. It's been brilliant. For those eagle-eyed or hardcore viewers of Honeybox, they might recognise you from Lymelight 2019.
Yeah, I did Lymelight in 2019 when the Honeybox did the stage as well. So, yeah, in a while.
How's this experience compared to doing it up there, sort of in the public? And
it's really cool. I've always wanted to do it in this way, like to the room. So, yeah, it's really cool. It's different and cool.
Brilliant. We're so delighted to have you here. So fill us all in. What have you been doing since 2019?
Since then, I've been releasing lots of music and things. And I played Lymelight Festival last year, which was really cool. And then I just released a new single the other week called Home. And been like enjoying the plays of that and stuff, people playing it, it's been really good. So yeah, thank you.
Fantastic. Home was one of the ones you played earlier in the show.
Yeah,
as well, wasn't
I played it?
It
the first time, so yeah.
Yeah, it's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And what plans do you have in the pipeline? Where can we see you? What do you have coming up?
I have a gig coming up at HMV on the 21st of January. I don't actually think it's a HMV here though, but yeah, plenty of gigs and a new song to also be released, the one that I played second here. So yeah,
amazing. That's wonderful. And I'm sure everybody wants to know how they can go to those gigs, where they can find out what you're doing, what you're up to. Plug your social, Charlotte.
My social media is Charlotte Bettson Official. That's my Instagram. But if you just type my name, Charlotte Bettson, anywhere, all the music platforms or all the social medias, it'll come up. And it's double T on the Bettson.
Fantastic. Thank you so much. You're going to do another song for us. What's your next song called?
This one's called Everything I Wish I Said to You. It's a bit of an older one.
Brilliant. Well, I'm going to stop waffling and let you get on with it. Enjoy Charlotte Bettson, everybody.
Everything I wish I said to you, all the things you
life goes on, I'm in a better place.
Okay, time for our final chat of the day then. It's with Cathy Jain. Hi.
Hi.
Are you enjoying your Honey Box experience,
yes,
Cathy?
Yes, I am. I've never done something like this before, so it's really cool.
I think before we get started, should we get a shout out to your drummer as well?
Imogen, my drummer since day one.
You guys did an amazing job. Now, last time I saw you, was you guys together at Cassia's, yeah. So support for Cassia in Manchester. So you're fresh off that. How was all that?
That was amazing. It was the first tour I went on, and those guys are amazing, so musically talented and wonderful people. So it was such a great experience.
How was being on the road as well for you? Because it was your first proper tour, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was really fun, actually. Got into the mojo of it and then couldn't really get used to it afterwards, going home and not going out and performing. So
last year was a lot of releasing stuff. Obviously, you ended it with an EP as well.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that for a second first.
Okay.
How was the release of that? What was that all like?
Yeah, it was really great. It was supposed to be released quite early on in the year, but I had to finish A-levels, so I had to push it
priorities.
Back quite a bit. Yeah, it's priorities, yeah.
So and this year is, I'm guessing, a lot more getting that out on the road and sharing it.
Yeah, definitely, like gigging and sort of meeting people and seeing where everything goes.
What's been the most fun thing you've done so far, would you say?
Since starting
all this, because it's been a bit of a whirlwind, hasn't it?
I think I would say the Cassia tour. That was really, really fun. Like, I really enjoyed that, so definitely.
Well, we're looking forward to a lot more stuff coming out from this year. I say a lot of gigs, hopefully we can check you out doing. So social media, that's the best place to go. Where are we looking for?
Yeah, I think just my name, if you search it anywhere, I'll be there. It's Jane with the AI instead of NE. So.
And what's the last song you performed for us today?
Soulmates.
Okay.
An unreleased song.
Unreleased, what's it about?
About two of my friends who won't get together even though they're into each other.
Amazing. Make some noise for Cathy Jain. She gets ready now, everybody. Before we get Cathy to play our final song for us, I can tell you that on the 29th of January, it's a double month for the Honey Box, we should be back with episode 3. We have got Mercury, Morning's Feet, and Voted Most Likely all performing for us. It's going to be a cracking little lineup. Make sure you're there 29th of January at the Honey Box, 4 o'clock, season six, episode three. That'll be, if you don't mind, live audience, make some noise for one final time for Cathy Jain. It's a tight squeeze and we laugh every time. Ooh.
tried to add, so really doesn't matter. Ignore the fact that it was such a show. Always knew I would wander away, but I could see you really like me. Sometimes girl gets
treadmill of education. Round.